The Commission on Elections is set to tap malls for the 2025 midterm polls. It also continues to conduct its Register Anywhere program to entice the public to vote in next year's elections. Victoria Tula now joins us with that story. Victoria, over to you.
Hermina, expect mall voting to happen again, this time for the 2025 midterm elections. This was the statement of COMELEC Chairman George Garcia this morning at the University of Santo Tomas, or USC. According to Garcia, because of the successful pilot run of mall voting during the 2023 Village and Youth Council polls, they will definitely implement this again. This does not mean, however, that voting in schools will no longer take place. Residents who live near participating malls will be asked by COMELEC if they want to vote there or continue voting in schools. Garcia assured that this will be of no additional cost to the government. The partnership will supposedly be beneficial to mall owners since more people will flock to their establishments and spend on food and other merchandise. The specific malls which will be used for voting are still to be identified. Garcia and other COMELEC officials were at USC for the Register Anywhere program. Under the said program, the poll body partners with schools, government offices, private companies, malls, and other establishments to bring voter registration to the public. Filipinos may also update their information, transfer registration, reactivate, and avail of other services. More than a month since the voter registration commenced in the country, about 1.3 million Filipinos have already registered, according to Garcia. They aim to register 3 million new voters. COMELEC also hopes to receive more budget in order to pay for the use of schools that will be voting venues. This is in line with the concern raised by Vice President and Department of Education Secretary Sara Duterte that public schools are made to shoulder expenses incurred during elections, such as bills for utilities and repairs. COMELEC is already in talks with the Department of Budget and Management. Carmina?
Thanks a lot, Victoria Tula, there joining us on the line. House lawmakers approve on second reading a bill seeking to revoke the franchise of controversial TV network SM&I due to alleged violations. House Panel on Legislative Franchises Chairman Gus Tambunting says there were no objections to the bill. The measure will be ripe for final approval next week, but it still needs a go-ahead from the Senate.
The documents that they were submitting to SEC and they were submitting to Congress were different. And this was confirmed by SEC themselves. Ito po yung mga katanungan na hindi po talaga masagot ng mga resource persons sa pinapadala po ng SM&I.
SM&I is the broadcast media arm of the Davao-based Church of Televangelist Apollo Kiboloy. The religious leader had repeatedly refused to attend the committee hearings, prompting lawmakers to cite him in contempt.
We have proof to show siya pa rin ang may-ari, no? Naka-layering. At ito po yung gusto namin tanungin sa kanya. And because hindi po niya, hindi po siya dumadat, nagkaroon po ng interest, no? Malaking interest ang media at saka ang publiko dito sa isyong to. Dapat po kung dumating lang po siya sa unang hearing, tapos na po to eh. Okay? Hindi na po lalaki.
Police officers involved in the arrest of filmmaker Jade Castro and his three companions facing administrative charges. Castro and his friends were released from detention Monday after a judge junked the arson charge against them. They were accused of burning a modern jeepney in Catanawan, Quezon, January 31st, even though witness accounts and CCTV footage showed they were nowhere near the crime scene. Castro and his group were arrested February 1st despite the absence of a warrant. The U.S. Presidential Trade and Investment Mission to Manila wrapped up with over $1 billion worth of investments. Jackie Pascual returns with a breakdown of those commitments.
U.S. Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo left the Philippines with over $1 billion worth of investments from her Presidential Trade and Investment Mission in the country this week. The U.S. Department of Commerce reveals much of the investments will focus on training programs and upskilling of Filipino workers to better equip them with the right tools for higher-paying jobs. Among the companies investing are Microsoft and MasterCard.
Focus on bringing 100,000 more learners with skills in AI fluency and cybersecurity very, very soon. This will focus on some curriculum courses in LinkedIn Learning.
Partner with Boost Capital to extend their financial services network to allow the training
of 10,000 Filipino small businesses to get access to the learnings that they need to thrive in the digital economy.
Other companies, meanwhile, will expand their presence in the country, like private equity firm KKR, which will invest $400 million more in Pinnacle Towers, the country's largest telco tower operator. The firm already invested $1.7 billion in the Philippines in recent years.
We've invested in a number of sectors here in the Philippines. We've invested in the healthcare industry via Metro Pacific Hospitals. We've invested significantly in infrastructure. We've invested in financial technology, Voyager, Pinnacle Towers, which is the largest independent tower co here in the Philippines.
There are also possible investments in the energy sector.
We're in talks to close a deal with the Boides Power. What our software does is it helps utilities innovate and make decisions up to 85% faster.
We will be making this type of panel. We have customers all around the world waiting for it. People often ask me, hey, what about China? Why don't you just get it built there and ship it into the Philippines? With this panel, we actually beat the cost of the Chinese right now.
UltraPass ID, meanwhile, has formed a partnership with the Department of Budget and Management and Now Corporation to improve cybersecurity.
We can secure government and commercial systems with much more secure login authentication protocols. There's some challenges here in the Philippines.
U.S. President Joe Biden's Export Council expressed optimism on the renewed economic ties between the two nations, saying there may be more investments.
I think there's huge excitement about opportunities for American companies in the Philippines to invest, to hire people, to help upscale people.
Aside from the 22 American companies who joined the trade mission, the Commerce Department said other companies have also expressed interest to expand in the Philippines, like Meta and Vita Coco. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.